Luckily, what I'm doing here is not brain surgery, because otherwise, if it was, then I would be in some serious trouble. What I'm doing here is I saw in Scooby, 1961 or 1969, or I don't know, but Scooby, he was showing, that's a video about 4 years old, and he was showing how he makes protein bars. And I wanted to make protein bars, but what I've been doing is the protein bars that I get, that I got, my wife actually got them for me, they have sugar, very, very high sugar content. The protein is like 15 grams, which is fantastic. Now 14 grams, which is fantastic. But then the sugar content is like 15 grams. So I'm having a little internal battle somewhat with trying to decrease my sugar intake. I'm not diabetic or anything like that, but I just would like to decrease my sugar intake, because I think that what it does is it makes up a lot of bad things to happen. It dries out my mouth. I think it also gives me constipation. I think it gives me causes me to have pimples or zits. Sometimes it gives me what's it, acid reflux. Acid reflux is more of overeating to me. But you know, just if I can decrease my sugar intake, then that would be great. And so anyway, so what I was talking about, Scooby, what he was doing is he was putting wax paper on a an 8x8 inch sheet, and that's what he was using as a container to put in his protein bars. And he doesn't bake, he doesn't cook them at all. So maybe I shouldn't cook them at all either. This is my first time. This is my first experience, so I don't, you know, I tried to do it on my own, but without too much, you know, without pissing my wife off too much, and do it inexpensively somewhat. So, what you can see what I'm doing here is I put in 2 tablespoons of oatmeal, rolled oats, and then I put before that I put in 2 tablespoons of flaxseed, and then right now what I put in just right there was in 2 tablespoons of peanut butter, and then all before all that, then what I did was I put in it was supposed to be 2/3 of protein, of whey protein. And what I did was I got 2/3 of a cup of whey protein, and I put it in the bowl. I put it in the cup, in the measurement cup measurement thing, and then I looked at a scoop, because if I look on the directions on the whey protein, then there's a scoop of whey protein, and they say that gives you 30 grams of protein. So anyway, I looked at the 2/3 of a cup, and then I looked at the scoop, and I was like, huh, well, they're about the same. So I figured, well, it would be good to just use a scoop, to 1 scoop would be good, and then that would get, I would get 30 grams and everything would be fine. What I did there also was that I added, I was reading, I think vegan, because they were talking about Green Life or something like that, .com. They were talking about making whey protein bars, or making protein bars that don't have any sugar, but have a bunch of protein in them. So that's what I was looking for, I was aiming for. And whenever I looked at that, then it said cinnamon, had a pinch of cinnamon. They're saying probably like a teaspoon of cinnamon and half a teaspoon of ginger. And the cinnamon, it has a little bit of a sweet taste to it sometimes, but the ginger, it doesn't have a sweet taste at all. It tastes pretty basic, I guess. It's not very tasty. So anyway, I put all those together, and I messed up because I put all those together in my pan. And whenever I did that, then I tried to mix it all up with the spoon, and that wasn't happening. So what I did next was I got a bowl. And, I looked at Scooby's video, and I looked at a couple other videos, and they all used a bowl. So I don't know why I didn't think about using a bowl. I should have thought about using a bowl. I thought it was going to be a little bit more easier to mix, but it wasn't. So I'm doing a bad thing here. I'm trying to transfer all of the stuff from the pan into the bowl so that I can mix up the con. And so what I did after I put it all in the bowl was that it says in the directions, it says you're supposed to use 1 2/3 of a cup of water. And you can mix that with almond milk also, which is preferably what I would like to do next time, hopefully. Because I don't think almond milk has a whole lot of sugar in it, so that would be something that I would be that I would like to do. But so anyway, I got some bottled water, and I got about 2/3 of a cup, not a whole cup, because it asked for like a cup plus 2/3 of water. But I remember from Scooby, he was saying that you kind of want it thick. You don't want it to be mushy. So what I did was when I added that 2/3 of a cup of water, then it and I started to mix it around, and it made it pretty mushy, pretty gooey. And so what I did after that, I said, well, I gotta do something to make this much more viscous, I guess is a good word there, viscous. So I figured, well, what I can do is I can add another scoop of whey protein, and maybe that'll add to the, maybe it'll make the mixture a little bit more viscous, or give it more consistency. So I added about 2/3 of a scoop, just coincidentally, and it was dumb luck. That's what it was, because I was looking at the, I was trying to compare the measurements because it said on in the scoop for the whey protein, it said it was 90 cc's, and when I looked at how many cc's are in a cup, there's like 237, about 230 cc's in a cup. So if you take two-thirds of that, then you end up with, I think it's 150 or something like that. So what I should have done was taken all that into consideration, and I should have put in one scoop plus 3/4 of the scoop. And so, and that would have given me the consistency that I was looking for as far as whenever I'm mixing the stuff up in the bowl. And like I said, it was just dumb luck because it worked out. I mean, that was just coincidentally it worked out that way. So that's what I did. I mixed it all up. It's still kind of runny. I don't like it. I don't like it being that runny. But and I think what I need to do next time is I think I need to make two batches of it next time. So instead of two-thirds of a cup of whey protein, I think I'm gonna do 1.5 cups of whey protein, and then I'm gonna do, what was it? I did 2 tablespoons of flaxseed, 2 tablespoons of rolled oats, and let's see, 2 tablespoons of peanut butter. But instead of those, that only 2 tablespoons, I would use 4 tablespoons next time. And you know, I heard that peanut butter will bind things. It will help bind things together. So I might add, instead of 4 tablespoons of peanut butter, I might add 5 tablespoons of peanut butter. But the peanut butter, the thing about the peanut butter is that's where most of my sugars come from. It's from my peanut butter. So I kind of got to be careful about that. 2 tablespoons was about 3 grams of sugar. So I think 5 tablespoons would be 7.5 grams of sugar. But whenever you think about putting that, whenever you think you can make 8 bars out of that, then, you know, the 7 grams of sugar, you cut that in 8, so you only end up with 1 gram of sugar per protein bar. So that would be pretty good.